Hello everyone, my name is Beatrice Boivino. I am the founder of Tenchi Taido Cookie Dojo and I lived in Japan 11 years and there I learned Tenchi Taido martial art from Master Hiroyuki Aoki and I also learned with Master Hiroyuki Aoki calligraphy. You can see one of the calligraphy I made last year. And today we will do something about calligraphy, but more like a game. That is to say, guess the meaning of the very old kanji, and then draw the old kanji and the modern kanji. So I'm very grateful to One Words Art Film Festival, and I'm very grateful to Master Hiroyuki Aoki. You can see Master Hiroyuki Aoki in a beautiful documentary called The 12 on internet. So let's enjoy together. First, I explain some things about traditional calligraphy. And then we will do just some movement to relax the body. And then we will draw. So the calligraphy come from China, and first it was on ox bones, on ox scapula. So it was like that. It was really like draw. Can you see? It's really drawing. Can you guess something? And then from there, it was on a pot, like that. It was on this kind of pot for rituals. And it's still like draw. And there it changed again, and it become progressively the modern calligraphy and the modern style. There is three way. That is to say, there is the formal way. There is a formal way that you can really easily understand. For example, this is the mountain. This is the formal way. And if you write a little bit faster, it's semi-cursive, like that. And if you write very fast, it becomes cursive style, like that. So this is the one for the mountain, regular, semi-cursive, and cursive. And if you look at the moon, this one, the regular form, the semi-cursive. You can see that it's more curved and more linked, and the cursive style. So, to write kanji, what do we need? We need ink. So, in the tradition, the thing that is used is ink stick. That is to say, this kind of thing. This is a ink stick. In Japan, they call that sumi. And how do you use it? You take a stone that is called ink stone, suzuri in Japan. This one is a little one, beautiful little one. And then you make the ink by rubbing like that, and then put water, and it make ink. So there are many kind of ink stick. This is another one. You can see something written on it, maybe. So this is the ink stone, suzuri. And the ink stick, sumi. But in the modern dates, people use sometimes liquid ink like that. So we have the ink. We need a brush. So there are many kind of brush too. You can see there is a very big one like this. You can see a smaller one. And you can see that there are also several kinds. Some are more strong, and some of them are more soft. And can this one is very soft. And if you write in a cursive way, this one is very good. And if you write something that is more straight, you will use this kind of brush. And when the brush is new, you can see that it's like that. There is some glue to protect the brush. So before the first use, you have to put in water and then the glue can dissolve. So we have the brush, we have the ink. So after that, we need the paper. And there are, when people are training, we use little paper like that. But there are many kinds of paper. Some are more soft, so some of them can absorb a lot of ink and some don't absorb a lot. And there are also paper with kind of a beautiful style and sometimes color. This one, maybe you can see, this one is very, very thin. Ah, it's difficult to see. And there are something inside. So we have the paper, the ink, the brush. What do we need again? We need this. This is a weight because the paper, as you saw before, is very thin. And when you write, the paper will move. So you put you put your paper and then you put the weight on it so that the paper won't move. And we have also this that is called in Japanese shitajiki. We put it under the paper because the ink is absorbed by the paper. And as the paper is very thin, if there is nothing under the paper, there will be ink on the table. So to protect the table, we put that. So we have all that we need to start. So before starting, as I said before, we are doing some soft movement to relax the body and to become one with our brush. So let's do just a little bit movement. Okay, so just start, jump a little bit to relax. Ichi ni san shi go yoku sit at you two. Ichi ni san shi. And then put your shoulders up and relax once more. And breathe in, breathe out. And the last one, breathe in. And then rub your hand. Swing like that. And then you can throw away everything. If there are some issues, throw away everything. and breathe out. Okay. And from there, when we write, we need to be relaxed, but also to expand, not to be like that. So to open our body, we open our feet as wide as your hips, and then make big circle all around. Open your hand very big, extend your arms, look far. And you can also have the image that your inner space becomes bigger, bigger and bigger. Your inner energy expands, your inner light. Once more. And the last one. Okay. And just to open a little bit more, let's open our chest. To open in this way. So with one step forward, open. And then relax, come back. And once more, open. And the last one, open. And okay, relax. So when we are writing, we are connected with our brush, but also with the sky and with the earth. So let's stand a little bit. Your body is straight. Your feet are open as wide as your hips. And close your eyes a little bit. And you can feel the ground, the floor under your feet. Your soles are connected with the ground, with the floor, with the earth. And you can feel the sky, the heaven above your head. And you can feel the energy of the sky, the light coming above your head. And going into your head, your neck, your shoulders, your chest, your heart, your spine, and the light is coming down and down in your body, in your belly, your hips, your legs, your knees, your feet, your soles. And going down into the earth, down and down like roots. So you can feel you are connected with the sky, the heaven, and your body, and the earth. So let's take the brush now. So before using ink, usually we put water. And how do we use the brush? First, take it with the left hand on the base, and then put your right hand horizontally. And then you can take the brush like that. And you can make like a circle here. Your energy. It's like before we open our body, so we have this open feeling, and we are connected with the sky, the earth, and the brush. So when we write, we don't put the brush like that. The brush is connected with us, and with the sky and the earth. We have our spine inside our body, and the brush is a little bit like a spine too. So if we move, if we write, we move like that. So for example, let's So a little bit more. So if I write standing, I move, I bend my knees and I move like that. It is not like that or like that. I am connected with my brush, with the heaven, the sky, and with the earth. So we move together. So let's start. So for those who follow last week workshop, maybe you remember, first, it's like in sports. In sports, we do some stretching when we start. So there is also a kind of a warming up here. And the warming up is to write some lines very slowly. So let's start by the line. So for the position, you put your left hand on the paper, open, it's like the circle before, and don't put your paper too close to your body because the circle of your energy won't be here, there won't be place. So put your paper a little bit wider and you are face to your paper and put some ink and then your hand horizontally, your brush vertically, and then let's just do a line. Very, very slowly, very slowly. It's a kind of meditation. And you continue the line until the end with the same whites, and then you finish the line. Ah, I have to move a little bit. You can see well. So I have to move this one. There. Okay, sorry. So let's do another line. Once more. So it's really a kind of meditation. We have to go down before writing. So let's start. You can make a little circle to start and then go slowly, very slowly. And you can see that my brush stays vertical. My elbow is open, my right elbow. And then come back. How is it? We will do kanji after. Don't worry. It's just the warming up. But it's important. Make it easier to write after. So we are doing the last horizontal line, and the feeling will be to remember all your life from your birth and the school when you were a child, and the school after, and maybe friends, some holiday, and maybe some work according to your age, and until your life now. So the last horizontal line, remembering all the events of your life. So write very slowly again. So make a circle, And then, very slowly, remember everything. Your friend, your family, some nice souvenir, some birthday, maybe a marriage, wedding, party. And okay. Okay, so let's do the next step now. In the training, people do this kind of thing sometime 4 years and do many, many, many lines like that to become very down and very concentrate and thinner line, wider line. But let's continue for today. So the pressure is also different when you do calligraphy. That is to say, you can be just there, or you can press more and more on your brush. And if you press more, it will become bigger. And then you can press less, very slowly again. And then press more and less and more and less and more and less. Okay. It depends on your brush. Sorry. And let's do once more. So one again. So you can press and then release. And press and release and press and release and press and release. To be honest, I went a little bit too fast. It's really something very slow. So we did some warming up. How does it look for you? Mine is like that. How about you? Good. So let's do the next step. Do you remember what we did last week? Last week we did this, and the evolution from the old to the modern one was like that. Do you remember what it was? It was the mountain, Yama. And the most famous mountain in Japan is Fujiyama. That is called also Fujisan because it's a sacred mountain. So we did that. We did also the river. Do you remember the river? This was the river and the modern form of the river with the water going like that. And the water in Japanese is called kawa. And the old form of the river is like that, like a road, but with water. So we did this one too. Do you remember the name of a famous river in Tokyo? This is Sumida, and then Sumida Dawa. And we did also this one. Do you remember this one? Old days and nowadays. You can draw it in a round, more round form also. It was, do you remember? It was a tree that is called in Japanese ki. And if you put two trees together, it becomes a little wood, hayashi. And we didn't do last week, but you can also put three together. So one tree ki, this one. Two trees together is little wood. So what, how about this one? Three trees together. It is Mori, the forest. So there are many trees. So this is a forest, Mori. So this was last week workshop. So how about today? Let's do something new. So for today, I prepared some paper. Do you remember the fan? We looked at this fan last week. Let's saw the river. The old form of the mountain. So let's do something new. For example, how about this? The old form can also be this one. Very simple. Can you guess what it is? You can see it during the night. It's the moon. And in Japanese, it's called Tsuki or Getsu. So you can recognize very easily the form of the moon. And now the modern form of the moon is like that. So if you watch a Japanese calendar, the first month is called Ichi Gatsu. Ichi mean one, first, and Gatsu is the word for moon in Japanese. So Ichi Gatsu is the first month of the year, that is to say January. And two is ni in Japanese. So ni Gatsu is February. That's it. So the modern form is this one, and the old form is this one. So let's do the old one first. So let's take a paper. Move. So you can see both like that. Oh, okay. You can see both. Perfect. So for the old form, there is no rule about the order because it was engraved and it was in the old days, so We don't know how it was written. So let's do first, let's do the curve. Always very slowly. Let's do the curve. And then the vertical line, very slowly from up to down. In Japan and in China too, people write from up to down and from left to right in one character. So this is the old form of the moon. Do you remember the name in Japanese? Getsu or Tsuki? So this was the old form. Let's do the modern one. This one. So for this one, I'll show you the order. This is like that. So first, you do this line vertically and with a little curve at the end. And the second one is starting here and go to the right and then going down and end with a little comeback. And after this one and this one. And you have your getsu, your tsuki. So let's do it together. A new paper. I have too many papers. Yeah. Usually, your table should be completely white. The space is clean. So, let's do the moon. In the modern calligraphy, in the modern way. So first, you make the first vertical line slowly, and you finish with a curve to the left, and then restart at the beginning point, go a little bit upper to the right. You can make an angle here and then go down, 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 and to the end, just a little comeback. And after that, you make the little line inside from left to right, and one again from left to right, and you have the moon. Okay, you have the modern form of the moon. And the old form that we did before, this is Tsuki Gatsu. Okay, so the video is ongoing, so you can do it after that several times. So let's continue for the next one. Time is going fast. So the next one. What is it? What could it be? There are something going down, maybe. So the modern form, I'll show you the modern form. The modern form is also easy to guess, I think. It's very similar. This one. So this is the rain. This is the rain. So you can understand this is the sky. And the water is falling from the sky. And in the modern form too, it's easy to recognize. There is always the sky and the water going down. So first, I didn't tell the name of the water in Japanese. The name of water in Japanese is ame. Ame. Pronunciation here. Ame. So let's do first the old form. So the old form is very simple. So let's do it together. A new sheet of paper. So you can see both. Maybe I could put it like that. You can see better like that. And I will write. So first you do an horizontal line from left to right and slowly again. And then you can do the water falling down to the earth. Very slowly again. And the last one. Okay. How is your water? Does it look like this one? So ame, water, in the old form. So let's do the modern one now. So for the modern one, this one. So I put it there. So you can see, and the order, you start from the left to the right with an horizontal line, and then you do a vertical line in the middle, and then you do a vertical line on the left. And the fourth one has two strokes in the same line, going there and then vertically. And then the water, this one, this one, this one, this one. So let's do it together. I put this here so you can see what I'm doing. So let's do the next one. Water, ame, in the model form. So first, the horizontal one from the left to the right. And then the vertical one going down and then the vertical one on the left and then the horizontal one. And then going down again. And come back a little bit. And then the water going down and going down. And on the right too, going down and going down. Okay, how about your rain, Ame? How does it look like? So this is the rain, Ame, in the old form and in the modern form. The old one and the nowadays. Okay, oh, time flies. So after the rain, what will we do? There are so many I wanted to do. Let's change style, let's change way of thinking. How about this? What could it be, this one? It is a flower, a tree, or an edge. This is a child. In Japanese, they say ko. You can see the head, and the arms, and the body. It's a little child. And the modern form is like that. So it's a little bit different as usual, but it's cool. A child. So let's do the child together. So first, the old form. Of paper. I love this one. It really looks like an angel. A very cute child. So there is, for the old one, as I said before, as it's very old time and it was engraved, so we don't know, there is no rule about the writing, so you can start from where you want for the old form. So first you can make the head always slowly. And then we can make the body going down and finishing by a curve. And then We can make the arms. It's an happy child. He seems to enjoy the situation. And then finish. How about your child, the co? Is that okay? So let's do the modern one, the modern form now. So for the modern form, there is the order. So start from the left ear, go to the right, and in the same line, that is to say, you don't release your pen, your brush, in the same line you go there, it's the head, and then the body is here, going down and a little bit up, and then the arms are there. And you have co, the child. So let's do it together, the modern form. Where did I put it? I have many papers now. Up. Can see both. Like that. And a new sheet of paper. You start from the left with a horizontal line going a little bit up maybe, and then turn and go down in direction of the center, and then the new line is starting there, going back with a nice curve. And finishing, going up a little bit. And then doing the arms, starting to the left with an horizontal line. And extend the arms. And okay. And you have your child. Your lovely child, with a modern form, like that, and the old one, where is my lovely little child, there it is, co, the child. So this is a child. So the last one we are doing now is this one. We are doing only the old form because time is flying. Could you guess what it was? It's a woman, Onna, and the modern form is this one. Can you see? So you can, maybe you can guess, in Japan people were always on the floor, so maybe she's on the floor, and this could be arms, her arms, very open, like to keep a baby. So let's do this one. And it's Onna. So new paper again. So for this one too, you can do what order you want because it's all fun, so there is no rule. So first I will start here and go down and then legs and the knees maybe and going up and maybe the foot, big foot. And then the arms, very gentle arms. Always going very slowly. And then joining the arms. And this is the woman in the old form, Onna. And the modern form, we don't have time today to do it, but let's have a look. The modern form and the old form, Onna, the woman. And the last thing, let's guess this one. We won't do it, we won't draw it, but just to guess, what could it be? Last time I talked about combination to make new kanji. So maybe you can recognize we just did that. Look at this part. It's similar, isn't it? So the woman and this one, this lovely little one, the one that we did before, the child. So together in one kanji, it's only one kanji, it's not two, the woman and the child. What could it be? It is to love or to like. You can use the same word for love somebody or like something. If I, for example, if I love Marie, I will say Suki, Marie ga Suki. The modern form of tsuki, the pronunciation, is this one. So you can recognize also, in both you can recognize the woman on the left and the child on the right. It's a new kanji, a new combination, and the pronunciation is tsuki. So I have to stop now, it's time. So thank you so much for joining this workshop. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'm very grateful to Once Words Art Screen Festival. If you enjoyed this workshop, don't forget the donation button. And don't forget also to have a look about many amazing performances during the festival. Until tomorrow evening, and it will be also ongoing, I think, a little bit after, but enjoy today and tomorrow, and thank you again, WAF Festival, and everybody, and thank you for joining, and if you want to know more, my name is Beatrice Boivino, and you can see my email on the Wandsworth South Wind website. It's Tenchin Taido Cookie. Thank you, bye!